Hello friends and my dear students. Today we are going to learn about Leptospira and Borrelia. So these two, they belong to the family Spirochetaceae, and they both are causing the bloodstream infection. So when we are dealing with the bloodstream infection, so we should keep Leptospirosis and Borreliosis in the mind. So today we will learn the patient having the infection of leptospirosis and the Borrelia infection, how these patient presents and how we can diagnose these cases. So this Leptospira that belongs to the family Spirochetaceae, and these spirochetes, they are spiral in shape. That is why they are belonging to this family, and they are spirochetes, and they are very thin, flexible. So these Leptospira, they also have the hooked ends, but they are very thin, so we cannot see these bacteria with the help of the normal microscopes. So we need special microscope for these bacteria which belong to this family. This Spirochetaceae family, one member is also there, that is Treponema pallidum, but we will not talk about this Treponema here, because we will read in the sexual transmitted diseases. So here we are talking about only the bloodstream infection. So therefore I am only talking about Leptospira and the Borrelia. So for these bacteria we need a special microscope, that is a dark field microscope or the phase contrast. So there you have a better contrast and you have a different background, so that will help you to see these thin bacteria. So they are very thin and we need the special microscopes. Now they have these Leptospira, they have the hooked ends and they are actively motile. They have the endoflagella. They have two type of movements, translational as well as rotational. This genus Leptospira, it is classified into two species. One is the Leptospira interrogans, another is the Leptospira biflexa. So interrogans, jitni bhi aapki pathogenic strains hai, all which are pathogenic means which are causing the disease. So they all are interrogans, or biflexa jo hai, they are saprophytes. So they are not causing any disease. That you can see Leptospira. Now this Leptospira is further comprises of serovars, serogroups. So that is based on the lipopolysaccharides. And this Leptospira interrogans, they have it has 26 serogroups, which is further being further divided into 300 serovars. So according to the different geographical distribution, then so they are present. Different serogroups, serovars are present in different geographical areas. And then this Leptospira biflexa, that is also multiple serovars and serogroups. Then we comes to this epidemiology. So first of all, this leptospirosis is a zoonotic disease. So what do you mean by zoonotic disease? That means we are getting this infection from the animals. Direct or indirect contact with the urine of the infected animal. So mainly we are getting from the rodents. So here we have to remember three R's, which are the important risk factors. How we can get this infection, that is the rodents. Second is the rainfall, that is during the rainfall, floods. So these are the important risk factor. And third is the rice fields. Now the maintenance host for this bacteria are the small mammals, and who all people are at risk? Those who are coming in contact with the animals, like farmers are there, veterinary doctors are there, then rodent control workers are there, so they can be at risk for leptospirosis. So in the recreative activities also we can get this infection, like in the water sports, adventure sports. Then how it can be transmitted? That is occurring through the abrasions or the cut in the skin, or the through the conjunctiva. Risk factors, I have already told you, that is occupational exposure hai, like veterinary doctors hai, all those who are controlling the rodents. And rodent itself is a risk factor. Rise, rainfall, lower socioeconomic status, slum areas, when there is any rainfall or floods. So globally, more common this leptospirosis has been seen in the Brazil, India and Thailand. And in India, maximum cases are being seen in the coastal district of Andaman and Nicobar. Then Gujarat is there, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra. Then and many more other states are also there where we can see the leptospirosis. Then comes the pathogenesis. So the pathogenesis of this leptospira infection is divided into two parts. One part is for the septicemic phase, that is the first part. Then comes the immune phase. In septicemic phase, like this bacteria enters your body either through the mucosa or through the abraded skin. So once it enters your body, it will then enter to the your bloodstream. And through that, it will move to the different organ, that is known as a dissemination. So through the blood, it will reach to the various organs, including your brain, lung, liver, heart, and kidney. Then comes, so at that time, when the this bacteria is in your blood, so you will have the symptom of like fever, flu-like illness. Then comes the immune phase. So after approximate 7 to 10 days, the antibody against this bacteria will start be producing, and these antibody will form the antigen antibody complex, and that will be deposited in various organs. So at that time, these leptospira, they will be excreted in the urine. How the patient of this leptospirosis is being presented? So patient kis tarah se aayega, that is the first, jab uska septicemic phase is going on, once enter kiya, so at that time fever will be there, and it will be flu like illness. Flu jaise aapke normal jo bhi viral infections ke jo symptoms hote, flu like illness means viral infection ke. So the patient will be presented with the myalgia, headache, then there could be conjunctival redness, then वॉमिटिंग हो सकती है, एब्डोमिनल पेन हो सकता है, सो ऑल दैट कैन बी देयर. एंड मेन थिंग इज दैट इट विल बी द पेशेंट विल बी अनएक्ट्रिक, दैट मीन्स देर विल बी नो येलोइंगनेस ऑफ द आईज. सो जॉन्डिस के फीचर्स नहीं होंगे. देर कैन बी सेकेंड स्टेज कैन बी देयर, दैट इज द इम्यून फेज वेन इट विल गेट एक्टिवेटेड. सो एट दैट टाइम देर बी कैन बी सर्टन कॉम्प्लिकेशन लाइक मैनिंजाइटिस, UVitis हो सकता है, optic neuritis, rashes, fever, all can be there. So one is the mild, that is patient mild presentation के संग आ रहा है. Second is the severe form. So 80 to 90% cases में it is a mild infection only, but 5 to 10% they can go in the severe form of the disease, that is known as Weil's disease. Now what is this Weil's disease? It is a hepatorenal hemorrhagic syndrome. Hepato means liver involvement is there. Renal means kidney is getting involved. Hemorrhagic means bleeding spots are there, and it is a syndrome. And there the patient will also manifest with the jaundice also. So it is a severe form. Only 5 to 10% patient will land up in this Weil's disease. A short note can come either on directly on leptospirosis, or it can come on the Weil's disease itself. So how the patient of Weil's disease, that is the high grade fever will be there. Jaundice, 5 to 10% people can show jaundice, and hemorrhage condition like in lungs may ho sakta hemorrhage, then petechiae, purpuras, then in conjunctiva you can see the hemorrhage, or in the GI system. Then kidney effect ho sakti hai. So kidney may, that you can see when you will go for the investigation, so creatinine will be high, or this serum urea can be high. So patient can also land up in the renal failure. So that you can see how the patient of leptospirosis, on the hand you can see the these rashes. Now how we can diagnose the case of leptospirosis, that is the lab diagnosis. So first of all, what samples we can take? That is when, like in the first phase, I am saying the patient will be having those symptoms. So in the first phase, when the bacteria is in the blood, so you can have different samples, blood, you can have CSF or this peritoneal dialysis fluid. Then in the after the 1 week of illness, when these antibodies are formed and these complexes are being formed, they are being deposited in the kidney. So at that time, this bacteria start coming in the urine also. So after 1 week of illness, you can also can collect the urine sample. So how we can diagnose? First is microscopy. Directly we can see the bacteria, but ye bahut thin hai, so we need the dark field microscopy or the phase contrast. और क्या कर सकते हैं, वी कैन गो फॉर द इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंट स्टेनिंग्स. सो ऑल्सो लाइक इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंट स्टेनिंग वी आर डूइंग, वी कैन ऑल्सो डू द सिल्वर स्टेनिंग, दैट इज अ सिल्वर इम्प्रिग्नेशन स्टेनिंग, सो दैट यू कैन सी द लेप्टोस्पाइरा, दैट इज अ डार्क ग्राउंड माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ द माउथ. Then molecular techniques, we can also go for these, but one problem we can face that we cannot identify the serovars. Like species are there, then they are further classified into serogroups than serovars. So serovars you cannot identify using this nucleic molecular techniques. Then culture, this is very important. We should know culture. If you are dealing with the bacteria or the virus, like in virus we are using the cell lines. Here we are using certain medias. So you should know how we can culture that bacteria. So blood culture lenge, because ye bloodstream infection it is causing. So blood culture, and probably as early as possible. Within the first week, there will be good results. So what media? This media is very important that you should remember: Ellinghausen, Macaulay, Johnson, Harris media, EMJH media. Or Fletcher's media. So this bacteria is a slow growing bacteria, and what temperature you have to give, that is 28 to 30 degrees centigrade. Usually in bacteriology, all the bacteria they grow at 37 degrees centigrade. So this condition you should remember in Leptospira, that we need 30 degrees centigrade for the Leptospira. It is a slow growing bacteria. It has a special media. Common media is used nahi kiya the, and almost it takes, you cannot declare up till you can wait for 13 weeks. So we do the like we have inoculated the sample, and we take these we do the dark ground microscopy to see the motile bacteria. Then serology, that is the gold standard method which we are following, that is the microscopic agglutination test. So this microscopic agglutination test, how we perform, that is in the microtiter plate, जिसमें हम ELISA करते हैं. So the microtiter plates are being used, and what we take patient का हम क्या लेंगे, serum. So patient serum will have the antibodies. अगर patient को infection हुआ है Leptospira, so the patient will have the antibodies against the Leptospira, and then we will add live antigen suspension of different serotypes which are common in that area. Us area mein kaun sa serotype common hai Leptospira ka, that we will add. So if the antibody in the patient are against those antigen which we have added, so they will react, and we can see the agglutination. How you will see, that is using the dark field microscopes, and then we can have the titer, that is dilution method. Se you can know the titer also. So this is very important. Reference labs, this microscopic agglutination test is being done. It is also gold standard method. Other methods, macroscopic slide agglutination, latex agglutination, ELISA, and rapid CARs are there, ICT. Then we can go for the animal inoculation in the hamsters, young guinea pigs. Then comes the treatment, how we can treat. So drug of choice is penicillin in case of leptospirosis. That can be given this given dose for 7 days. Then alternatively we can go for ceftriaxone or ceftriaxim. In the mild cases, oral doxycycline for 7 days. Then comes the Borrelia. So that also belongs to the same family. It also has the these spirals. But what is different that the spirals are not equally spaced. So spirals mein jo spacing hai, that is not same in all the spirals. That is how we can distinguish between the Leptospira and the Borrelia. And another spirochete, that is a Treponema pallidum, that is also a spiral. So in that, they are equally spaced. In Leptospira, they are equally spaced as well as they are hooked. That is the name Leptospira. Then comes the Borrelia. So they are unequally spaced. So these are large refractile spirochetes which have the irregular spiral coils. They are highly motile bacteria, also have the endoflagella. And these spirochetes like this Treponema pallidum or this Leptospira, they cannot be stained. But this Borrelia can be stained, gram staining, although not so good, so they are gram negative. So this is only the spirochete which can be stained, that is the Borrelia. It is gram negative. Three species are common with this human infections. That you can see the Borrelia, that is the gram-negative staining. So Borrelia recurrentis, Vincentii, bug Dorferi. So recurrentis is causing relapsing fever. Vincentii does not cause the bloodstream infection. But as I am covering this Borrelia, so I have included one, two slides of this Vincentii also. So I have a very little much knowledge, but that doesn't come in the bloodstream infection. Then Borrelia bug Dorferi, that cause the Lyme's disease. So this Borrelia recurrentis causes a relapsing fever, means the fever is coming, then it is subsiding, then again it is coming. That means relapse. Fever aaya, phir chala gaya kuch din ke liye, phir se aa gaya. So that is very important when relapsing fever is coming, that can be of a Borrelia infection. Now two type this infection we can get, that is one is the epidemic relapsing fever, another is the endemic. So epidemic is transmitted by the louse and endemic is transmitted by tick. So these are the agents which are transmitting this bacteria and causing the infection. Now louse borne relapsing fever or the epidemic, they are transmitted from person to person through the louse. And the endemic one, that is transmitted by the tick borne. And that is this bacteria, they live in the rodents, and when this tick feeds on these rodents or the mammals, from there they take it and they transmit to the human beings. So epidemic or louse born human to human ye, but endemic mein this tick born mein aapke animals and rodents, they are also involved. So louse borne that presents a more severe clinical picture. So in that case, the presentation of the patient will be more severe. And how this is being transmitted, that we all know, that is by getting crushed and rubbed in the abradory skin. But it is not transmitted transovarily. Pathogenicity, how the patient of this presents, that is the patient will present with high grade fever, chills, severe headache, myalgia and severe malaise. Then there will be the fever attacks which are mixed with the afebrile period. That means fever will come, then it will go, then again the fever will come. Along with that, the patient will have the rashes, hepatic splenomegaly, jaundice, and sometimes they can be involvement of respiratory system or the nervous system. And that can occur due to the acute heart or hepatic failure, or they can be the cerebral hemorrhage. In lab diagnosis, we can do the microscopy, that is the peripheral blood smear, or we can go for the direct fluorescent antibody test, or by the direct this dark ground microscopy or the phase contrast microscopy. Molecular methods you can have, serologically ELISA, immunofluorescent assay are there, GLPQ assay are there. Culture, it is slow and time consuming, and we can also go for the animal inoculation. Treatment, doxycycline, this is the drug of choice. Alternatively, we can go for the erythromycin also. Then comes a Borrelia vincentii that cause a Vincent's angina. So Borrelia vincentii एक normal commensal है, आपके mouth में normally रहता है, but certain condition में it can give rise to infection like of viral infection or the patient is malnourished. So that can lead to the gingival stomatitis, that is the infection of the gingivas, or oropharyngitis. So that is known as the Vincent's angina. So when this Borrelia vincentii along with another bacterium, that is a Fusobacterium fusiform, so dono milke ye aapka oral infection karte hain, gingival stomatitis, and they can these bacteria can also be found in the lung abscess, skin ulcer, that can also be done. How you can demonstrate that is aapne jo bhi exudates hain, you can make the smear, you can see the this bacteria, and penicillin and metronidazole can be given. Now comes the Lyme disease that is caused by the Borrelia burgdorferi. It was the newly identified spirochete disease and it was first observed in the Lyme of USA. Therefore, it has been named as Lyme disease. It is also a vector-borne disease. So, it is a zoonotic disease, tick-borne. So, ticks se transmit hoti hai and humans are the dead-end host. So, it is a very widespread disease in the USA. Which tick is this? Which is spreading? That is the exudid. Clinically, there are three phases are there. The incubation period can be of 3 days to 1 month. So first jo symptom aayega early, jahan pe bite kiya hai tick ne, so there will be a lesion. Second mein wo disseminate kar jayega, and third mein late stages mein there can be arthritis, that is the Lyme's arthritis. Usually the infection is self-limiting. So that you can see at the site of the bite, this is a expanding annular lesion. So at the site of bite, they, first of all, there will be first lesion at the bite site that you can see where the bite, tick will bite. So there will be a growing in the margins, expanding erythematous annular lesion, and that is known as the erythema migrans. Second stage mein jab wo infection spread kar jayega, burgdorferi ka disseminate, so fever, fever, headache, so all those symptoms of the flu-like illness. Along with that, arthralgia or the lymph node enlargement, generalized, that is all over your body, generalized lymphadenopathy. In the late stage, which is months to years later on, the patient can have the arthritis, typically of the affecting the knee, and that is the Lyme's arthritis, and then the polyneuropathy. So that is how the patient of this Lyme's disease presents. How we can diagnose? So skin lesions you can take, or the CSF, or the blood. So you can inoculate in the, there is a special media, modified Kelly's media, that is a BSK media. Serologically, first we go for ELISA. If ELISA comes positive, then we have to confirm by the Western blot. Molecular techniques more useful when we take the joint fluids. Other samples we are not getting good results. So serologically it can be done. Treatment, that is the doxycycline, that can be given depending upon skin ka infection hai or its involvement of the knee joint also, or joints involvement. So the duration will be prolonged treatment. If there is involvement of CNS system, so ceftriaxone is given for approximate 4 weeks. So that is all for this important bloodstream infection, that is the leptospirosis and the borreliosis. Hope you must have understand. If you have any doubt, you can mail me. Thank you.